If you're watching this the day it's uploaded, it's because today I just hit 100,000 subscribers on this channel. And I'm gonna explain in this video how I went from being a nobody living in the middle of nowhere to becoming an overnight success with my YouTube channel, which allowed me to build a successful business that allows me to do this full time. Simply put, I didn't. I'm assuming that's not what you were expecting, right? See, the truth is, I did not become an overnight success. What everyone sees is the fact that I went from 1,000 to 100,000 subscribers and over 4 million views in less than a year and a half on YouTube. But that's what everyone sees. Just because that's what you see from the outside looking in, that's not necessarily reality. See, the story of reality has something different to say. So let's just rewind a bit so you can see that the real story is one of frustration, failure, me quitting, and thinking it would never happen. Because the truth is that I actually started this channel in 2016, 5 years ago. And I made videos consistently for about 6 months with virtually zero success. And they were not good. The video quality was not amazing. I really didn't know what I was doing. I didn't understand titles and thumbnails or really how to do anything to grow my audience. So in 6 months, I got a few hundred views on my videos and maybe like a couple hundred subscribers, and I quit. So the reality is I got burned out. And at that point, I had graduated college, had already been writing, producing, arranging, and doing lots of freelance work professionally, from scoring short films to producing artists to classical commissions, arrangements, and whatnot. And I have been doing it for several years at that point. And I was at a point where I was essentially tapped out creatively and felt like I needed to step away. So I did. I quit the channel. And I even quit music for 2 years. Then in 2019, I came back. I realized that I really couldn't live knowing that I didn't give it another shot. I vividly remember driving and asking myself this question: where am I going to be in 5 years? And I knew that it wasn't doing what I was doing. I knew it was getting back to making music, producing, making videos, and building my own online business with music. So, over 2 years later, I came back. I began uploading again, and in early 2019, I became a student of YouTube. I studied. I listened to every podcast I could, watched every video on YouTube growth I could. I learned everything I could about YouTube. I began investing in myself in terms of video equipment. I began learning more about making videos, editing, filming, lighting, just everything. And it began the journey again. And at first, it was slow. Again, not a lot happened. I posted videos, but they didn't pick up. In another 6 months or so of that before my channel actually saw any real growth. So I ended up crossing my first 1,000 subscribers in early 2020, about 3.5 years after I started. 3.5 years to get to 1,000. And I remember a conversation I had with my wife in early 2020. And I said that if I could end 2020 with 5,000 subscribers, I'd be so happy. Boy, I had no idea what was about to happen. See, through all of this, I began working my butt off to improve the video quality, improve my organic growth on YouTube, and in April of 2020, my first video popped, 40 Advanced Tips and Hacks in Logic Pro. The funny thing is that that video only got maybe 1,000 views in the first month, but then with COVID, Apple gave a 90-day free trial for Logic, and that created a surge of people looking up Logic Pro tutorials. And it turns out mine fit the bill for what people needed and wanted. And a bit over a month after that, I had 10,000 subscribers.
10,000? 10,000 subscribers? Thank you guys so much, seriously, for all of you that have contributed to the channel, for subscribing.
It was like a switch of a light. And then I realized, this is possible. That right there is the real rub. I realized and saw with my own eyes, this is possible. And when that happened, there was a really big mental shift. That's when I went all in on YouTube. I decided that I was gonna focus everything on YouTube entirely. I made it my full-time job, even though it wasn't quite yet paying the bills. I got YouTube Partner within a month, which is monetization, and then I started making a bit of money there. It wasn't a lot, but then I started producing artists again. I started teaching again and started really getting serious, and that is when everything changed. I started uploading regularly. I started increasing the quality every single video. I worked my butt off every day to make sure that the channel was the best it could possibly be. And by the end of 2020, I had 30,000 subscribers. Remember, I said I'd be excited about 5,000, right? But what you need to know is that I had built up a catalog of videos. So when that first video popped, it wasn't just a random big video and then everything dropped off. No, it was a progression of that one video doing well, which then led people to watch other videos I made. So it was all a chain reaction. If that first video would have exploded and there was nothing else for people to watch, well then what do people watch next, right? Someone else's video. They'd have to wait till the next one, which by then, it's probably too late. I worked insanely hard on these videos that I thought were just not doing well, But in reality, I was building up a catalog of videos so that when that first video really did well, all of a sudden, people can go watch the other videos I'd poured all that time into. The next big moment was December 31st, 2020, the last day of the year. I released a video called Pro in GarageBand versus Beginner in Logic Pro. That was the first real attempt at making a viral video, we'll say. A video that was more entertaining than educational because I knew that while I love teaching, I wanted to just make awesome videos about producing music and have fun and entertain and teach at the same time and do something different. And that video exploded. It got 100,000 views in the first week, and today it has almost 800,000 views. And January was insane. I grew by over 20,000 subscribers and ended with over 50,000 subscribers by the end of the month with over 600,000 views in January alone. And the same thing happened as before. This one video exploded, but ultimately led to more people going and watching what other videos I had made. I had some videos with less than 5,000 views end up getting 50 to 100,000 views in only a few weeks because all those people watched that first video and then moved on to watch the next one and the next one. In the next one. Again, it's a chain reaction. And all year, I've been testing and working on improving every video, trying new ways of doing videos, new types of mediums, new shooting styles, new editing styles, new methods. So all of this year has been one big test to try to figure out how to keep growing, how to keep going, and how to innovate this entire channel and do what other people aren't doing. And the beauty of this is that I have found a way to create my own lifestyle apart from the traditional music industry, where I have total control. I don't need a record label, I don't need a manager, I don't need to have anyone running this for me. And I get to do this full time, making a great living, a better living than I've ever made before. I have relationships with companies like Native Instruments, Personas, Sweetwater, Monogram, Jay-Z Mike's Baby Audio, and more. These are companies that I never thought I would ever have a relationship with. So, in many ways, this is a dream. It's crazy. But to say that it was an overnight success, no. All of this came with the price tag and I had to pay it. You don't see the heartbreak behind these walls of failing. You don't see the conversations I had with my wife trying to convince her that it could work, that I could do it. You don't see the times I thought to myself, how on earth will this ever happen? And how on earth is this ever gonna work? You don't see the times that I've tried something new and realized it was a total failure, but I have to try again. You don't see the thousands of hours of work it takes. You don't see the choices I've had to make. You don't see the sacrifices, the tears, the late nights, the early mornings, the pots of coffee, the new skills I've had to learn. You just don't see how much it actually takes. You just see the result. And that's okay that you don't. This is not a knock on you or even me saying I should get a big pat on the back. But for those who want this life, it is possible. But it is not possible without an enormous amount of belief, hard work, sacrifice, and an unwillingness to quit. I quit once. And now that I see what's possible, I will never quit again because I believe it's only a matter of time. It's a matter of hard work. And it's a matter of taking the lessons that you learn and improving upon them. Truth is, while I just hit 100,000 subscribers, this is just the beginning. I'm not thinking, wow, 100,000, I made it. No, I'm actually thinking, okay, cool, how do we get to 200,000, then 500,000, then a million? And not in a cocky kind of a way, but I'm just not the type to settle. And I know that we are still just scratching the surface with the channel. I'm hiring people to work with me on the channel. I have a video editor who's been coming in to work for me. I've begun hiring out a film crew to shoot videos for future videos that have not yet been released. I have a marketing manager. I've grown a full-blown business with this. This is just the beginning of my journey. And maybe once we hit the next milestone, I'll do this again to reflect and show you what's possible. So for those who are dreamers like me, dreams without intentional action will be just that, dreams. If you want to reap the rewards of those dreams, my best advice is to take aggressive action. Stop waiting, stop planning, and just move. You cannot steer a ship that's not moving. And to those who have been following, thank you. Ultimately, you made this possible. I cannot believe that I get to do this for a living and that it provides for me and my family. Thank you. Thank you. We'll see you soon.